LPG gang, what's happening? Let me change the color in here. Let's do purple. Yeah. All right. Take what resonates. Leave the rest. Take it how it resonates with you and your situation, okay? Personal readings are in the description box on the website, y'all. Hit those likes. Hit those likes. Hit those likes. Hit that subscribe. You are greatly appreciated. All right. So let's see what's going on here. I usually take the top one, but let's see, my dear collective, what's going on. So some of you dealing with a love bomber, self-absorbed, narcissists, all that good stuff. Somebody's heartbroken. So we have date. This one is getting back out there, meeting someone new, setting a date online. Okay. We have the golden mirror. This one is narcissist, love bombing, self-absorbed, and one-sided. So some of you are dealing with a breadcrumber, somebody breadcrumbing you. Then we have passion. This one is insane chemistry, sparks and having fun, equal interest and burning desire. And then we have heartbroken here. Yes. And this one is deeply hurt and sad, feeling lost, grieving in despair and break up. So someone's going through some things, collective. Okay, well, we'll see what's going on. Nine of Wands. Now, this is an interesting energy under date. So are some of you dating and you're determined to find your partner, or you're determined to find your match, collective? Let's see what is going on here. Someone could also be like feeling a way because you're dating or you're out and about and doing you. That is the case for some of you. I'm not gonna take any of these, but okay, somebody got her fine and they stressed out about it. Could be look what's under there. Could be an Aries for some of you. Somebody feeling some type of way. Okay, well, we have the Eight of Wands. I think this is two cards. We have the Empress card. Ooh, and we have the Six of Cups. Okay. All right, I'm liking the energy so far. Now, what I'm not totally sure of yet is who is the love bomber here. Is it you, collective? Seven of Cups are on the bottom. Yeah, somebody got options. Someone is feeling away because you are you're dating, you're enjoying your life, you're looking better than ever. Some of you have dropped some weight. Some of you guys may be like posting stuff about your life and stuff on social media. Like, some of you are like getting back out there. Someone sees you as very attractive. Like, you know, you may have children with this person as well. It's like, oh, for some of you have children with this person. That could be why they feel so territorial over you. Like, yeah, for some of you, that could be why they feel so territorial over you, because y'all have children together, or they wanted children with you, collective. Take that how it resonates with you. But I do feel like some of you are, someone's missing you a lot. It's like they're thinking about you. They're missing your nurturing energy, you guys. They're missing how you treated them. They're missing how you made them feel. They may have tried to, you know, seek other people for a source, but it hasn't quite worked out. Yeah. I feel like someone, the Hermit. Somebody is obsessing over you. Could be a Virgo. The Moon. Yeah, someone, I feel like whoever this is, was trying really hard to like control their emotions, and I feel like it didn't turn out the way that they wanted it to. They kept a lot in, they kept a lot to themselves, and so it did kind of look like this person was, you know, love bombing you or one-sided or whatever, because they kind of kept a lot in and kept a lot from you. I feel like they didn't really express a lot of emotions to you. They didn't really open up to you a lot. And you didn't know where you stood with this person, you guys. Wow. No way. The lovers. Someone sees you as their person. The nine of... Yeah, someone feels very territorial of you. The nine of wands again. Yeah. It's like... We were supposed to be. We were supposed to work out. That's kind of what I'm getting with this. Whoever this is very concerned about you seeing other people. Or doing you. Some of you may be having a good time, even if it's not like dating other people or whatever. There is something here with your energy that you are like kind of enjoying your life. You're like participating in a lot of self-care. You're putting yourself first. You're putting your happiness first. You're putting your satisfaction first. And I feel like that's important. That's something that you needed to do for a lot of you. It could be this person. I'm not going to take this one, but this one almost flipped out. The Five of Wands. Yeah, somebody's willing to like fight for you or fight your options. Child, please. Page of Cups. Yeah, some of you may get an apology from a person. Now, with the Page of Cups came out with the Two of Swords. Yeah, some of you may get an apology from someone. Ten of Pentacles here on the bottom. Yeah. I feel like some of you guys, you had a family with this person, or you had children with this person, or this person wanted a family with you. They want a family. They want children with you. And this was like their goal. Like their goal was to have this dynamic with you. And I'm assuming some of you guys are broken up, because this is heartbroken. This breakup here. So again, take that how it resonates with you. That's not going to resonate with all of you. Some of you are going to get an apology from someone. Mm-hmm. A very heartfelt apology from them. Could be because they were super closed off. They were selfish. Someone here realizes they were very selfish in the connection. You know, they may have been a love bomber. They may have given off narcissists to you. Okay, but I don't feel like that's their true self. I feel like they did that because of, you know, not really wanting to open up. That was like their shadow self. Not their true self. This is just someone that portrays themselves to be one way, even though they're not really like that in real life. A lot of you kind of got turned off from someone. Yeah, Ten of Wands. Yeah, someone's not very happy about you moving on and seeing other people. The Moon. Yeah, this is something with their emotions. Someone hid their emotions. They actually feel very deeply. Page of Cups. Yeah. Someone feels very deeply. Very, very, very deeply. They may have also been like in a past connection or a past relationship where it went really terrible. Like it went really bad. And so it kind of put this person in a lot of fear and a lot of trust issues. Whoever this is operates from a lot of fear. The Hermit with the Moon, that's someone that keeps their feelings and their emotions to themselves. They try to keep their insecurities to themselves, but they come out in different ways. You can never really keep everything to yourself, especially when you are communicating with someone. It comes out in different ways. Sometimes in anger, outbursts, sometimes with insults. Sometimes people will insult you, you know, out of the blue for no reason. But it's really how they feel about themselves, right? So I feel like that is what's going on. This person tries to hide their insecurities. They try to hide their... you know, their fears and things like that, but it comes off as narcissism. You ever met someone that, and I've met people like this where like the first initial conversation is, oh, well, I'm an alpha and I'm this and that. But if this person was really an alpha, they wouldn't have to tell me that. You know what I'm saying? Like someone like kind of gassing themselves up, overly gassing themselves up, you know, so you don't see their insecurities, but what they're not realizing is it's actually showing their insecurities even more. Yep. Wow. No way. Are you serious? Collective, listen. Someone feels like you're their divine counterpart. Whoever this is feels like you're their person. And again, it could be vice versa. Wow. Wow. And you may have had a very good chemistry with this person. But this person desires coming together with you. They desire having this victory with you. collective. It's insane. It's insane. I feel like they're kind of willing to do whatever to make this happen or make this shape. But there is a trust issue here, though, collective, that needs to be addressed. Mm-hmm. The world, yes. So reconciliation for some of you. If this person wanted to reconcile, if you two are separated, I'm seeing the Knight of Swords, the Ace of Cups, and the High Priestess. Yes, someone wanting to reconcile with you. Also open up, tell you everything that's been going on with them. You know, tell them what the real is. Because I feel like whoever this is, they may have came off as a narcissist. They may have come off as a love bomber, but it was because they were trying to hide who they really are. This person has a fear of being vulnerable. They have a hard time showing vulnerability to people. So it comes off as, you know, I'm trying not to say what I was going to say. I'm trying to find a PG version to say it. It comes off crappy, I'll say that. You know, it comes off as this person being hard to deal with. You may have seen this person as like hard to deal with. I'm going to say hard to love because I feel like you kind of still love them despite that, but hard to deal with. But it's because they let pain and trauma in their past dictate them, you know, dictate their life to the point where it became a burden on you. But it ultimately is becoming a burden on them as well. Okay, so I see an apology for a lot of you. Like this person apologizing or just trying to make things right. Because ever since y'all have been broken up or fell off or whatever, I feel like this person hasn't been right. They haven't been right since. And I feel like they've really, really been looking at themselves and what they could have done better in this connection. Wow. I'll do a couple of handwritten's before I... Let me shuffle. Yep. Mm-hmm. I'm going through a lot right now. I can believe that, especially with the moon here. This person is really, really, really being forced to see themselves. And I feel like it might be hard. But I also get some shadow work going on with this person as well. And when you're not, so there's a blessing in this lesson fell out into my hand. I'm going to go ahead and take that. So if you are in separation from this person, I feel like it was needed. Whatever this was needed, collective, okay? Because it was kind of a hot mess. Like I said, I feel like a lot of you guys, you felt like this person was a burden to you. And I'm just being honest. You felt like they were hard to love, hard to deal with, hard to be around. Because they wouldn't open up. I feel like everything was a fight to this person. Very selfish, breadcrumbing, you know. Like I said, they may have given off narcissist vibes to you. I love you. Mm-hmm. Splitting the deck again. This fell out. I'm leaving them for you. Now, this could be them leaving someone. I don't really see that in a spread, but I feel like for some of you, the them could be like a past situation, like this person being stuck on somebody that hurt them in the past, whether it be family member, whether it be a ex-spouse or whatever the case may be, this person being hurt before and kind of taking it out on you, if that makes sense. Yep, shuffling again, I'm seeing Worst, I Assume by JoJo. This song is literally talking about what I'm just talking about, where this person assumes the worst. She says in the song, I keep assuming that you're going to do shit that might break my heart. So I keep up my guard. So I'm telling you, this person went through some things before and it took it out on you. So it's like, you know, it made it hard for you to really be there for this person and really like tolerate this person. I really like you, XO. All right, let me pull up a few of these and get off of here. Let me take you on a date. Mm-hmm. I'm wondering if for some of you, this is a new person. Nobody feels as good as you do. Or you have started seeing someone else and this other person is a past person. Some of you may have moved on. I told you. This person has a lot of fears and insecurities, and it just comes off as them being a fucked up individual, but that's not really how they are, okay? They just do that from, it's a protective mechanism. Can we at least be friends? Yeah, especially if you've moved on. A lot of you have moved on. I'm about to call/text you, or you want to move on. One Wish by Ray J. Everything I said was genuine. So whatever they said to you, collective, I'm ready for real this time. This person may even be willing to like have be friends first, like date, and go through the motions and stuff with you before, you know, taking things further or forward, like doing things the right way. This time I feel a strong connection with you. Yeah, definitely. I get that vibe as well. Ready for love. So, like I said, this person is like preparing. But I feel like you are too, you guys. Like you are in this space of being ready for something genuine. Do I Ever by Tony Stiff. Now, this song is about somebody crying. I told you. Hold on. Where's my hands at? Where's my hands? I'm good, man. Damn, I'm good. I want to do things right this time. I told you. It's like they want to go about it in a traditional way, especially if you guys started off rocky. And like I said, you know, this person came in as the in and out, the off and ons, the love bombing and things like that. Nobody Else by Summer Walker. All right, you guys, hit those likes. Hit that subscribe, y'all, if you want to see more. Again, I appreciate you for tuning in, y'all. Peace out.